everybody, live on 2K Sports alongside Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. I'm Kevin Harlan.
All right, what's up, guys? What's up, guys? This was a requested game, so let's get to it.
And the Bull. Start out with the Bull. Let's check out Chicago's starting lineup. D. Rose and Jimmy Butler, the backcourt. Inside at the 4 and 5.
Yep, great pass, Jimmy.
And it's Dunleavy in at the small forward.
I must have a lot of Chicago Bull fan subscribers because the Chicago Bulls is like the most requested team that people want to see.
Outside Butler. From deep, Rose.
Come on, Rose.
Well, what was supposed to be the triumphant return for Derrick Rose a year ago quickly turned into another nightmare season. Finally returning from that torn ACL in the 2012 playoffs, he managed only 10 games before tearing the meniscus in his other knee. Just devastating. We obviously hope that Rose can come back and put in a full season.
And so it's the Warriors getting on the board first. And Butler gets it to go.
It was almost like he was surprised to be that wide open, yet he knocked it down.
And the Warriors with possession here. Curry kicks to Barnes.
Oh, good steal.
He feeds it to Dunleavy.
Come on, Dunleavy. Oh, so you make that, but when playing the Atlanta Hawks, you miss.
Dunleavy's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball. Here's Golden State. It's a three-point game. Barnes sets a screen for Curry. Dishes it to Barnes.
Oh, good block by Noah.
Three on three.
What a pass. What was that, Rose? Come on. You could have did some twisty, funky shit in the paint and score that.
Dishes to Green. Wants to get it to Iguodala and does. Can't hit from in close.
Good defense.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
Rose passes to Butler. Off target from three-point range. The Warriors have gone 1-3 from the field to start this one so far. Thompson with it, and Rose picks him up defensively.
I was not paying attention, actually. So.
Bulls have gone 2-5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game.
And the there we fucking go.
Well, they just gave him 2 points. Defensively, you're going to have to tighten things up here. That's not a good sign.
And the Warriors off to a slow start here, trailing by 5. Not a lot of people thought, Steve, that Chicago had a chance last year to do much when Derrick Rose went down, but they stuck with it and ended up in the playoffs nonetheless.
And they didn't just make the playoffs. They had home court advantage in the first round as well.
The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Come on, Dunleavy. You know better than that.
We'll go to the line. That one on Dunleavy.
Unfortunately for the Bulls, home court advantage really didn't do much for them as they dropped their first two games at home and were bounced in the first round. Another example of why home court advantage is desired, but it doesn't necessarily guarantee anything in the playoffs. Matchups drive results.
Gasol.
You got that, Gasol. Here we go.
Fouled, and he's going to the line for one more.
You know, when the size advantage is that pronounced, I mean, that's exactly what you should do offensively in this situation. Take it strong to the middle.
The Bulls shooting their first foul shot of the night.
And you look at the numbers, guys, this team shot a 73% clip over the course of last season.
And, you know, whenever they get into a stretch where it looked like maybe they would turn it around at the line, they would immediately take a step back.
Here's Thompson.
And it's yeah, that wasn't going in.
Rose against Curry. Back to Rose. Shoots from the baseline, and that is good. Rose has got his second basket.
A 12-2 run.
Well, the Bulls ran into a solid Wizards.
But I'm not going to count out Golden State just yet because they definitely can make a comeback.
A healthy Bulls team with a little more depth is definitely a threat to go deeper this season.
Now here's Iguodala. The pass to Barnes. Back to Iguodala. Just 5 on the clock. Here's Curry.
Step up. Oh, come on, Noah.
Coming off Iguodala's feet. Curry's got his first bucket in this one. Chicago leading by 6. 107 left in the first quarter. Noah kicks to Butler. Noah with a screen on Thompson. Thompson against Butler. Shot clock at 5. Here's Noah, and the Bulls tack on 2 more.
So far, so good for them at the offensive end here in the early going.
Boy, the field goal percentage is fantastic. Exactly the kind of start they were hoping for.
Curry dishes to Barnes.
He had the chance right there to go. Protect the paint.
There's 39
nope.
seconds left
to play
in the
thought.
First quarter. Great defense that time from Noah.
Yeah, that was great defense.
Like defense inside, really protecting the rim.
Challenging shots and making his presence felt around the rim, that's exactly what he can give you.
Now here's Rose.
Don Levy. Oh, come on.
Thompson outside. He dishes it to Curry.
Oh, he's flopping.
Uses the glass that time, and it's good. Curry's got his second bucket of the night.
What a great possession, guys. He got a really good look there.
Rose goes in with the shot.
Oh, he got it!
Boom!
Buzzer!
Knock it down!
Shot.
Right at the horn! And an ideal finish to the quarter for them as he drains it at the buzzer.
Boy, I like the fact he didn't rush it at all. Fantastic shot.
Now the second quarter getting ready to start up.
All right, we're killing the Bulls. I mean, not the Bulls. We're killing Golden State right now.
To establish a rhythm and a pace to this game.
And I like that they're finding ways to score. Playing well here, Steve.
Warriors trail.
We're going to make sure they don't have a comeback.
Mike Dunleavy, the former number
three. Well, I'm going to try to make sure they don't have a comeback.
Duke, Steve, back in 2002.
Yeah, he played on that Duke team back in 2001 that won the NCAA championship. Played alongside Williams and Boozer. You know, never really became a star, but a quality player over his 12-year NBA career.
In a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. Setting the floor for the Warriors. It's Lee and Bogut inside. Livingston is out there with Barbosa.
Don't know much about Taj Gibson post game. Come on, Aaron.
Some nice ball movement by the Bulls.
Make that three. Was that a three? No, apparently two.
Brooks has got the lead up to 8 now for the Bulls.
And Mike Dunleavy Jr. is the son of a former NBA player and coach, Mike Sr. Actually, I played against Mike Sr. during his days. And Mike Sr., the dad, was a 6'3 point guard. Mike Jr.
Damn, Lee, how'd you miss?
Because of that exposure to his dad's game, Mike Jr. has always had great ball handling skills, even at 6'9.
Now here's Butler. David Lee missing his last shot. Butler attacking.
He's flopping. Heinrich board three. Oh, come on, Heinrich.
Double digits.
I tell you, he had all the time in the world to get that shot.
Ah, fuck, I couldn't choose.
Rim is shaking.
You know, sort of surprising he goes for a slam that difficult while they're trailing.
Yeah. Get across that line. Don't take your time.
Magnificent move to the rim.
Agreed. Guys, look, I don't know what the
no,
score is.
No, I fucked that up.
Remember from this game.
And Chicago has possession. The Warriors making the shot.
Miritic. Is it, I don't know if it's Miritic or Miritic.
A player that just does not excel at fighting through contact on his way to the rim.
Lee is screen on Brooks. Livingston kicks to Lee.
Nope, just give me the ball.
Pass to Livingston. The feed to Iguodala. Baseline jumper. And that one hits back iron.
You know, that's a problem he has, not being able to knock down that open jumper. I think it happens far too often.
The Warriors packing Oracle Arena, but plans.
Oh, come on!
San Francisco waterfront by 2018. I've seen pictures.
Don't get a foul.
I can only imagine one of the great fan bases in all of basketball. Change of location from their original intended spot on the piers.
Iggy's not going to shoot that.
Bay about a mile south.
And a new coach.
Yeah, that's right.
Now here's Iguodala. He trains it as the
shot. Oh, yeah, right.
Iguodala's got 6.
I like the way they're working the ball inside because when you do that, you get higher percentage shots.
Okay, I guess we're going to need to play through Jimmy Butler, I guess.
And Doris Burke has a report for us from the sideline.
Gentlemen, a close partnership between Bulls coach Tom Thibodeau and center Joe Kim Noah. Noah said, quote, the way each of us sees the game can be totally different, but he'll
okay.
fight anybody to win.
That works too.
And I will too. Noah says,
I'm not going to complain.
He's opened up a lot more, asking how we're doing, what we're thinking. Kevin?
They're really the backbone of that team. Thanks, Doris. And the Warriors decide to take their first time out here.
Well, and you look at the hurdles the Warriors had faced with their planned arena site on the piers. Political, bureaucrats, financial issues, and the cost of renovating the piers. But with their new site, those issues pretty much gone. Easy to see why they went in another direction.
Looking at who's out there now for the Warriors. Green, he's checked in for Bogut. Barnes comes in for Andre Iguodala. Thompson, he's checked in for Leandro Barbosa. And Curry's...
Oh, good steal. Good vision.
And Mirotic.
And Derrick Rose left wide open.
Oh, good with the triple.
And for the Warriors, a new line called the Central Subway under construction.
Heinrich, why didn't you jump? Play some damn defense. Don't stand in front of them and don't do nothing.
And that's really good to hear, especially for Oakland fans still hoping to attend the game.
Here's Gibson following the basket by Stephen Curry. 59 seconds left in the first half of basketball.
Ooh, got him. Get it. Ah, I fucking hate when they do that.
Taking it the other way. Now here's Curry. He has six.
I'd be damned if he makes that. Okay.
One wide left.
And that's a shot he had to take.
For sure, it was a good decision, just poor execution.
Heinrich inside the three-point line. Rose kicks to Mirotic.
Gasol's not really doing anything to get
Heinrich
open.
Up top.
I should have taken that shot with Heinrich.
Rose against.
Oh, he's flopping.
Rose, good. Rose has got his third basket of the night.
He's such a well-rounded offensive player. He's got a little bit of everything.
We got to get Derrick Rose going. Oh, Curry,
way to play and attack.
All right, we got to get Derrick Rose and Paul Gasol going.
And you're going to foul? Make sure it's a good one. They did, preventing the and one.
This is his first trip to the line tonight. And he makes the first. Bulls making a switch here. And both free throws good for Curry.
Boy, that was solid. I tell you, he's one of the best there is up there at the foul line.
Here is Rose. Dunleavy for three.
I should have taken the shot earlier. I don't know why I waited.
It's the Bulls. They're up by four. And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Hey, Kevin, with Derrick Rose. Derrick, how does it feel to get back out there on the basketball floor here for the new season ahead?
It feels good, man, especially playing with my teammates. We have new teammates. We're just trying to come out here and just play hard and compete.
Great to have you back, Derrick. Kevin, back to you.
Thank you, Doris. And we'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half.
I didn't realize Derrick Rose had a lot of tattoos. I didn't even know he had a tattoo on his hand. That's really amazing. I really don't pay attention to the players' tattoos. Stephen Curry only has 8 points. Gasol has 5 rebounds. All right. Okay, let's just get to this damn third quarter.
Welcome back, everyone. The second half about to get underway, and it's been a close one so far. One guy who's been getting it done so far, Stephen Curry.
Clay created a lot of opportunities for himself in the first couple of quarters. And tell you what, he was smart with his shot making, too. Really took good ones.
You know, points per shot attempted is really one of the undervalued stats in the game, and it's a real measurement of efficient scoring.
Here's who Tom Thibodeau is starting the second half with. D. Rose and Jimmy Butler, the backcourt. Inside at the 4 and 5 are Gasol and Noah.
And it's Dunleavy in at the small forward.
And a chance here to catch up with the fourth member
of
our crew.
Nope, because he's in front of him.
Hi, Doris.
Oh, no, don't do that to me.
Draymond Green, a second-round pick in 2012, but his tough defense and high basketball IQ have earned him minutes. He said, quote, I never cared about stats, and I still don't. My goal is to have an impact on the game.
Get that out of here. How is...
with plays that don't show up in the
and he's going to make it.
Those are the plays I live for. Great attitude, Kevin.
A real gamer, Doris. He loves the game. Thanks. Chicago leading.
People knew that he could shoot the ball coming out of college, but I don't think teams knew that Klay Thompson would develop into the dead-eye shooter that he's become. He is a flat-out laser. He can go to get into zones where he just doesn't.
Oh, he is flopping, and that was way late.
The Warriors shooting 47%, pretty solid. Iguodala dishes to Thompson.
Get it?
Good. That would have tied it.
You know, typically, guys, he has the body control to finish when he's in that tight. I'm not sure what happened there.
Rose kicks to Dunleavy. Here's Gasol.
Oh, wow, I can't believe I got that.
Fade away. Gasol's got his second bucket of the night. Third quarter here, over a minute and a half.
We're going to be going to Gasol for a while. Maybe. We'll have to see how it plays out.
Outside. Passes it to Kerr. Green with a screen for Kerr.
No! Oh, we got it! Did we do it?
The pass to Kerr. And another shot. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
Harrison Barnes, the seventh overall pick in 2012 out of North Carolina. He's got prototypical size and athleticism for that small forward position. Still developing his overall game, but he's got enormous potential.
Here's what Chicago's going with right now. Taj Gibson's checked in for Gasol. And it's Brooks.
All right. Let's do this.
Good on the second free throw. And Barnes, the top overall recruit in the nation coming out of high school in 2010.
Yeah, and really high expectations for him from a relatively young age. There's been some disappointment in his development, but with his work ethic, I think it's short-lived.
No, fuck.
Now here's Butler. Dunleavy for three, and it's good, assisting on the play.
I take it to when you can make a three. Dunleavy's took a big risk, points. Though, giving it to Dunleavy, who hasn't been doing any. Oh, he's three for four? Holy shit.
I mean, defense did not.
But those couldn't have been three-pointers.
Called the Warriors.
Chicago really struggled scoring points without Derrick Rose, and that's understandable. Last year, and against the West, it was even more difficult.
And the Warriors with some changes. Andrew Bogut checked in for Draymond Green. Barbosa comes in for Klay Thompson. And it's Livingston in for Steph Curry. Mirotić is checked in for Chicago.
All right.
Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half. Barnes kicks to Bogut.
Good defense. Good pass. Good vision, I should say.
Now here's Brooks. He's covered closely. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Feeds it to Noah. 6 feet out. Another one falls for Chicago. As you said about the Bulls, guys, just a very tough time scoring against the Western Conference, which would be their downfall, you know, Steve, most games.
Well, they shot right around 42% from the floor against the West last year, and that put them in the bottom three in the league. So I mean, you're just not going to get away with.
Come on, Jimmy. You know better. Oh, okay. I see the contact.
The Warriors shooting the sixth attempt at the free throw line tonight. Free throw drops for Barbosa. Third quarter here, and 3 minutes have come off the clock. Now here's Brooks. He's guarded closely.
I didn't know.
You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist numbers. And theirs are fantastic.
It's just beautiful basketball to watch, Clark.
Here is Livingston. The dish now to Barbosa. He kicks it to Livingston. Barnes against Gibson. Six to shoot. Now here's Barnes. Defense is right there. Can't connect from short range. Here's Miritich. That drops and it comes off an assist from Brooks.
Is this going to be... Never mind. I'm not even going to say anything because I might be eating my words later.
Shot for him right there, guys.
Livingston dishes to Barnes. Kicks it to Livingston. Takes the 13-footer. He squares up and sinks it. Livingston's got his second basket of the game.
Now, I want to see Sean Livingston do that in real life. Then I'll believe it.
Brooks, the pass to Butler. He feeds it to Gibson.
Gave you space. Oh, come on. Oh, good rebound.
Pass to Miritich from the arc. And again, it's the Bulls from deep.
Seems like guarding him on the perimeter is not a priority.
Good job, guys. Good job making shots.
He will become one if he continues to knock them down.
Livingston kicks to Bogut. Bogut with a screen on Brooks. It's rebounded by Noah.
Yeah, no excuses there. Got a really good look at the basket after being freed up by the pick.
We say it all the time. The execution was excellent. The result not as good, but good ball movement anyway.
Now here's Butler. 10-point lead. This is their biggest.
Oh, wow, that goes super fast.
Livingston dishes to Barbosa. Wide open look. And
yesterday. Oh, good shot.
Barbosa's got five.
I'm gonna make it one day.
And we've reached the end of the third.
No, haven't I made a full? I think I've made a full court shot before, but I don't remember.
Quickly, but we'll be back in no time with the start of the fourth quarter.
All right, come on, let's go. We don't got time for this.
Now let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
How about the creativity, guys? Terrific vision to pick out that pass and set up the basket.
Some serious creativity.
Okay, that I remember.
So it's Chicago now. Curry and Thompson, the Splash Brothers in the backcourt. Barnes and Lee are the 3 and 4. And it's Green in at the 5 down low.
That's not what I want you to do, Gasol.
And it's 7 points for Pau Gasol.
Yeah, no problem knocking down that shot. And a little more damage inflicted on another defensive lapse.
It's Thompson off the drive. Right wing. Nobody near Barnes. The offensive rebound.
A clear look at the hoop. He doesn't miss many of those.
Rose kicks to Dunleavy. Dishes it to Miritich.
No. Okay. Come on. Get in there. All right.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket coming off a pretty pass.
Well, if you just looked at assist as the measuring stick, they've been by far the better team.
Now, here's Green, back to Curry. And Gasol sends it back, and they'll keep possession.
Nope, that's coming off.
Chicago leading by 12. Rose goes in to the wing right side.
Shoot, I was going to pass it to Gasol if he would have stopped.
Gasol against Lee. Shoots from 12. Pau Gasol again. And an important part of every team's game, a look at the hustle stats for Chicago.
You know, block shots, guys, a clear indicator on the stat sheet.
They need a timeout.
Leaving them no room to get off any shots.
And another area where they've done a great job tonight is forcing the issue defensively and getting some steals.
Now a timeout called by Golden State.
Pau Gasol over the last few seasons dealing with a number of lower body injuries. Knee tendonitis, plantar fasciitis, groin, toe. Hey, Kobe had suggested him to try to really slim down to lessen the pressure on his joints.
Chicago making some changes. Joakim Noah is checked in for Miritich. And it's Jimmy Butler coming in for Kirk Heinrich. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Kevin, during that last break, I heard the Warriors coach as he addressed his team. He let his players know that they've got to do a better job on defense.
Oh, man.
They're scoring any way they want. We've got to show some pride here. Let's make a stand defensively, get us stops, and get on a run of our own. Do they have it in them, Kevin?
Now here's Butler after the miss from David Lee. Six to shoot. Here's Noah. It's Chicago with another bucket.
I would hope Joakim Noah would be able to make that over Harrison Barnes.
The burly type, but for seven-footers, getting as light as possible can really reduce the pounding on those joints.
Yeah, it does. It's, they say every 5 pounds takes some significant wear and tear off your joint. And we've certainly seen that be effective for Tim Duncan. He's leaned up considerably in power, able to play both power forward and center. I think the lighter weight will serve him well.
And here's Rose after the three-pointer from Stephen Curry.
There we
and
go.
The shot is good. And it's 8 points for Derrick Rose.
Boy, they look helpless defensively.
Thompson outside. And he's good on the three ball.
Back-to-back threes for him. Defense is slacking off a little.
It does look like their energy is lacking at this point.
The Bulls leading by 12. Pass to Dunleavy. Outside Rose. He dishes it to Butler. Dunleavy, the pass to Gasol. And the Bulls tack on two more.
Still went down, but with no defense anywhere near him, he might as well just go straight up. No need to fade away.
The Warriors have gone just 33% from the field in the fourth quarter so far. They are 2 of 6. Now, here's Thompson. Lee sets a screen for Thompson. Lets it go from deep. Another three for Golden State.
That's three in a row, guys. Three three-pointers consecutively. These guys are just raining in shots.
Yeah, the defenders can't be as soft as they've been on the perimeter there.
Thompson against Butler.
Oh, gosh.
Rose kicks to Dunleavy. Noah in the post. The jump hook, and he sinks that one, hitting the back of the rim on the way in.
An example right there, guys, of how even as their lead grew into a big one, they never started coasting.
That's the truth. I mean, they've been in charge of this game all the way through.
Now, here's Green. Lee. Good. Yeah. 102 left in the fourth quarter.
So it looks like just playing the last bit of this game out in what should be a nice win here for the Bulls.
Yep, it should be.
You know, I think the attitude was very impressive. Mm-hmm. And Clark, you had talked about this before the game. Definitely a competitive game, and they fought step of the way.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, that's all right.
Tremendous performance in terms of effort and intensity, and they deserve to win this.
Here's Rose after the made shot by David Lee.
Oh, God, that double teaming me. You can't leave Derrick Rose wide open. Oh, my God. I guess you can leave him wide open. He'll still miss.
Getting away from him.
Yep, it has gotten away. There's not really anything they can do now.
Barnes can't get it to go. For Chicago, they've gone on a tear here in the fourth. They're 8 of 9 on field goal attempts in the quarter. Butler kicks to Rose. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Here's Noah, and it's Chicago scoring again.
This is going to be a great game.
Does he do that every time he scores?
The NBA. Nice performance.
Any player loves sending his own fans home happy? He loves
sending
opposing fans home miserable.
Near the three-point line, it's Dunleavy. Misses. And so Chicago takes this one.